What's up, everybody? I'm Preposterous Miss Bradley, and welcome back to my Marchus Annus challenge. Today I drew Grunkle Stan from Gravity Falls, because if he isn't one of the best characters that ever was, then I don't know who is. He's such a mood. He's so relatable at the same time as being really old and unrelatable, and he like jumps back and forth, and oh my gosh, he's fantastic. Besides, I figured who else would live through the end of the world but Grunkle Stan? He's already great at social distancing. He already has a whole like lifetime supply of beans or something. Was it canned meat or canned beans? Yes, he probably has both. He's been investing in gold. And he punched a zombie in the face like it was nothing. He's got all sorts of weapons, brass knuckles. He keeps 10 guns in his house. He doesn't keep ladders because they're more dangerous than a gun. He's got this apocalypse thing down. He lived through Weirdmageddon, so why not the plague? Now, I haven't posted in a couple of days because, as you may have seen in my other update videos, which I may delete, which I may not, I don't know. Here in Utah, there was a really big earthquake, a 5.7 earthquake. Now, I have never felt an earthquake before, and it happened stupid early in the morning. It happened at like 7:09 in the morning, so I keep the worst sleeping time hours ever, right? So I had only had like 3 hours of sleep before that. So I was shaken awake out of a dead sleep. I thought somebody was pounding on my door, like double fisted, the way like my dad and sometimes my brother will wake me up that way, by like wham 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 on my bedroom door to wake me up. But at the same time, I thought somebody had run down the stairs really quickly. And at the same time, I thought somebody was like, had their foot on my bed and was pushing it to wake me up. It took a minute for my brain to wake up. The earthquake was almost over before my brain caught up and figured out what was going on. All of those earthquake drills growing up prepared me for nothing. I didn't know what to do. I still don't know what to do if there's another one. There's not gonna be another one because I say so. There was also quite a few aftershocks. One that day was like a 4.6 aftershock. That was terrible. Hated that. The aftershocks also went into yesterday. And so my nerves still haven't calmed down. I go from being really, really calm to being really anxious. Like a few minutes ago, a door slammed and I went right back into anxiety mode. So I should have recorded this earlier, but I was watching Steven Universe and oh my gosh, if you haven't seen those new videos, holy freaking crap. It took us hours to find my cat. He's an indoor cat. I knew he couldn't possibly be outside, but I couldn't find him anywhere inside. I just had a hunch and I looked behind the washer and dryer and there he was. So I'm really sad about that. He's fine. He's perfectly fine. He's still just as jittery and scared as I am. So we're feeding off of each other's anxieties. I have a panic disorder and generalized anxiety disorder. So I've been having a lot of really hard time dealing with that. Because like that's not something you can fight, that's not something you can rationalize away. I don't know. I'm sorry, I'm going really deep into this, but I need to vent about this a little bit, and I figured, hey, why not tell strangers on the internet my problems? They'll listen.
Maybe.
Anyway, we had to move the washer and dryer, and then I had to climb back there. And I had to like calm him down really good, and then I wrapped him in a blanket and picked him up and handed him to my mom, and he climbed right over my mom's shoulder, down her back, and went and hid under my bed.
My poor baby kitty.
He's not a baby, he's 10 years old. So yeah, nothing was broken. As far as we know, there's no damage to the house, and I'd really like to keep it that way. A lot of things fell over, like a lot of my Funko Pops, a lot of my figurines, like my giant Vanellope doll and my turret from Portal, both fell, took out the rest of my stuff. They were not prepared to stand up through that. I'm zoning out a lot talking about this. I'm sorry. But anyway, comment down below. Tell me what you want to see. As always, I might not get to it because we only have 11 days left. What is life? Where did this month go? But maybe I'll keep uploading stuff after that. Heck, I don't know. Anyway, I love you guys so, so much. Have an excellent day. Stay safe out there. Social distance yourself. Have a happy quarantine. And remember, memento mori, unus annus.